Hello and welcome to this session on JMeter. Today we are going to learn how can we test the performance of an email server, and to do that we will be configuring an SMTP sampler in JMeter that we will use to send emails from JMeter. So let us begin and let us see step one is, before we start creating our test plan, we have to add a jar and we have to add Java mail jar to JMeter. And we have to add it to the JMeter lib folder. Okay, so let us go to our browser and let us get this jar. So you can type Java mail jar and you will get a lot of options to download it from. I am using this particular site, and from here we will get the Java mail jar and download it. So you can go here and you can download this jar from here. Okay. So this will download it. As of now, I am cancelling this because I already have it. So once this is downloaded, what you have to do is you have to add this jar to the lib folder of JMeter. So in my case, I have already added it. Let me show you. And yes, here it is. So you can see this javax.mail jar is already added in the lib folder. And once you do that, you have to restart your JMeter. In case it is already started, you can restart it, and now this jar will be available. Let me also copy this link from where I have taken the jar. And now step two will be, you have to create a test plan, add a thread group, and then you have to add SMTP sampler. So let us go to our JMeter. And here in the test plan, we will add a thread group, and in the thread group we will add a sampler, and the sampler will be SMTP sampler. Okay, so we have added our sampler. Now we have to add the data to this sampler. Okay, so let me also write this down. Step three will be add data to SMTP sampler. Okay, now let us see what all things we have to add here. So number one thing, we have to add the server. Now let's suppose you want to send email to a Gmail account. In that case, the server will be smtp.googlemail.com. and again, if you are using some other email account, then accordingly you can search and add your server here. The port will be, you can use SSL 465 and you can use 587 if it is TLS. So let us try with 587. Okay. Now this connection timeout, if you give some value here, let's say if I give 20, then in case it is not able to send email within 20 seconds, it will timeout. As of now, let us keep it empty. Now here you have to give the from address. So let me give some email ID from where the mail will be sent. And here you have to send the to address. So let me again give some email ID. Other fields are optional. And in authentication settings, you have to use auth. Of course, if you are sending to Gmail, you will provide the username and password of the email ID. So I want to send it from here. I will provide the password. Okay. And then security settings, you can use SSL or you can use TLS. So because we have used the port for TLS, I'm using TLS, start TLS here. Okay. Now here you can put your subject. So let me say email from JMeter. Okay. If you select this suppress subject header, the subject will not be sent in the email. If you say include timestamp, then in the subject a timestamp will be added, and you can see that in the email. Let us not select it for now. Then message. This is a test email from JMeter. Okay, you can also attach files if you want. Send.eml means you can attach a .eml file which will have the subject body and attachments, everything. So you do not have to explicitly put the all the options here. As of now, we do not want that. Then we have calculate message size and enable debug logging. So this is, if you select this, it will show the size of the message in the response. And this is for debug. So let us not select this. This is the simple settings we have done. Let us test it. And to test, we have to add a listener. So let us add a tree listener. And let us also add one more listener, which will be a table listener. So we have two listeners and we have our request ready. Let us run this and see the output. So I have triggered this test and this is a failure and it is saying authentication failure. So let me go to my email and check what is the issue. I am getting response code 500. So it is saying it has the my credentials are correct, but because of security reasons, Google has blocked this sign-in attempt. Okay, so this will happen in case you are using Gmail most frequently, because Gmail tries to block any unauthorized sign-in attempts. So one of the things to take care here is you should be using the test email, which is configured either by your organization for this kind of testing, or if you are doing it for your own learning, then select or create a test email which is not your primary account. Otherwise, it can also block your account. So what you can do is, number one is you have to use your test account, do not use your primary account. Second thing is, if you get these kind of blocked exception, you can go to your My account. In your My account, you can navigate to signing into Google, and then if you go down, you have a settings to allow less secure applications. Okay, as of now this is off and that is why we are not able to sign in. If you want, you can make it on and then you will be able to send emails from JMeter, but I do not want to do it on this account. So what I will do is I will copy this email because this is a test account, and I will give this password, and again let me make this as the receiving email and the sending email is this one. And now let me run this. Let us see the results now. So I have changed the email ID and yes, now you can see this is a successful and it is saying message sent successfully. Okay, you can get the request and response, and in the table you can see it took 5610 milliseconds. And let us go to our email and check, and yes, we have received an email from JMeter. Okay, and whatever we have written in our sampler, it has come here. Okay, so now let us see. Let us increase the number of threads. Let me say this is, I want to test it with 5 users. So let me also write it down. Step 4 will be add listeners to view results, and step 5 will be run and validate. Okay, now I have increased the number of thread groups to 5, and in my SMTP sampler I can also, I want to check in my email the user that has sent the email. So I can also say, I can also write a function here, and the function will be to get the thread number or the virtual user number. So I can say dollar underscore underscore thread num, and we have already learnt about functions and variables in our earlier sessions. So also you can, if you want, you can go to options in your JMeter menu and you can go to function helper dialog, And here you can find all the possible functions which are available. So threadnum is the function. You can go to help. It will give you all the details about what does this do. Okay. It is saying here, the thread number function simply returns the number of thread currently being executed. Okay. So you can click generate and it will generate the function here that you can copy and paste. So I'm pasting it here so that in my email subject I get the number of the user count or the user number, and as well as here I will say virtual user number and this. Okay, let me run this now and let us see the results. Now see, it has sent the email 5 times. Let us go to our email and now you can see email from JMeter 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and even in the body we are getting the virtual user number. Okay, so this is how you can send email from JMeter, and then this is how you can do a performance testing on your email server. Hope you like it. Thank you.